We're going to get started in just a moment. Well, thank you all for joining us today for this exciting announcement. My name is Colleen Sklar, and I am really proud to be part of the creation of JQ Built Daycare in a Box pilot project. Before we get started, I'd like to acknowledge that we are gathered on Treaty 1 territory and that Manitoba is located on the treaty territory and ancestral lands of the Anishinaabe, the Anishinaabekwak, the Dakota Oyete, the Dene Suliné, and the Nahe Thawak. We acknowledge that Manitoba is located on the homeland of the Red River Métis, and northern Manitoba includes lands that were and are the ancestral lands of the Inuit. We respect the spirit and the intent of the treaties and treaty making and remain committed to working in partnership with First Nations, Inuit, Métis people, and in the spirit of truth, reconciliation, and collaboration. Well, I am thrilled to be asked to MC this exciting announcement and to be joined here today by our Premier, Heather Stefanson, Minister Ewasko, Yara Sachs, the Parliamentary Secretary to the Federal Minister of Families, Children and Social Development, and many of the pilot municipal participants such as Brad Erb, the Chair of JQ Built, and Sandra Smith, who is the Mayor of Stonewall and also will be welcoming us here on behalf of the town of Stonewall. Today's announcement is about critical daycare spots made possible through the Canada-Manitoba Early Learning and Child Care Agreement created by the federal government to support development of economic enabling infrastructure and return to work post-COVID. Here in Manitoba, our premier responded enthusiastically and created a unique and collaborative approach to expedite the development of daycare spots, attract providers, and make sure that every federal investment dollar counts for all Manitobans. It is now my great honour to invite Premier Stefanson to make today's announcement.
Great. Thanks so much, Colleen, and great to be here with all of you today. I just wanted to acknowledge Ralph Eichler, the MLA for this area, who's here with us today, as well as Ian Wishart, MLA for Portage-la-Prairie, and of course my colleague, Wayne Ewasko, the Minister of Education. Also want to welcome Parliamentary Secretary Sachs to Manitoba. Welcome, and to our other speakers here today, and to all of you for being here. And of course, most importantly, to all of these people who are here today, because this is what this is all about. Let's give them a round of applause. So thank you, Colleen. I want to thank you very much for everything today. I know that you have put, you and your team have put a lot of work into this, and I just thank you for everything that you're doing to move this forward. Well, Manitoba continues to be a national leader in providing affordable child care services. We recognize that our communities grow, and so too does the need for Manitoba families to access high-quality child care closer to home. This is especially true in rural communities, and it's the reason that we are gathered here in Stonewall today, and it's great to be back in Stonewall. As a government, we are listening, we are acting, and we are getting things done for the benefit of all Manitobans. And so today it gives me great pleasure to announce on behalf of the provincial and federal governments up to $70 million for 17 new child care facilities right across this great province of ours. This significant investment will create more than 1,200 new regulated nonprofit child care spaces across the province, with a focus initially on rural and Indigenous communities. These new facilities will be created in less than 1 year, reducing wait times for families accessing child care services closer to home. To achieve this goal, we are taking a unique and collaborative and community-led approach by using a hybrid construction process established by JQ Build to expedite the construction delivery of these new facilities in communities of great need. The first phase of this innovative project will create more than 650 new childcare spaces by next summer in 9 communities. That represents some of the fastest growing communities within our province. These projects and locations have been identified in partnership with local governments in and around the Winnipeg metropolitan region. In exchange for the facility building, participating municipalities will provide a minimum of 2 acres of service land with 15 years of free rent and support services, including snow removal, landscape maintenance, and repairs. This collaborative partnership will reduce the costs of the childcare operators, ensuring the long-term sustainability of these centers. Additionally, today I am pleased to announce that an expression of interest is also being issued to solicit proposals to develop facilities in more communities throughout the province, with up to 8 new centers and close to 600 additional childcare spaces to be identified by next spring. This investment supports our commitment to develop 23,000 new regulated not-for-profit childcare spaces for children under age 7 across the province by 2026. I think today's announcement is another example of the great things that we can accomplish when we all work together. I want to commend the many partners, stakeholders, reeves, and mayors, and community members who played an absolutely integral role in seeing this unique and significant first-of-its-kind project come to life for the benefit of Manitobans, their families, and our communities and local economies. I especially want to thank Brad and Colleen and your team at JQ Build for your innovation and design work that will enable municipalities to quickly bring these spaces to their community while supporting economic development and improved quality of life. Access to high quality childcare services is essential for Manitobans to be able to enter or re-enter the workforce, upgrade their skills and training, support their family, and play an active role in the growth of our communities and the growth of our economy. Today is a great day for the future of our communities and the future of our province. Thank you for being here, and I look forward to seeing these centers open their doors very, very soon. Thanks once again to Colleen, Brad, to others, to all of the municipalities who are represented here today, and First Nations, Pegwis First Nation is also a part of this, so those 9 communities that will benefit from this today, and 8 others through the expression of interest. This is an exciting day for Manitobans, and thank you all for being here for this exciting announcement today.
Well, thank you, Premier Stefanson. Through your leadership, vision, and active support of partnerships, local leaders, CAOs, community experts are working alongside the provincial experts and with community providers, essentially breaking trail and creating a process so more communities, large, small, rural, urban, northern, can participate and get more daycare spaces faster and more efficiently. It is my great pleasure now to introduce Minister Ewasko, the minister responsible for early learning and childcare in Manitoba. Minister Ewasko was an advocate of this collaboration and ensured the vision of this project was seen through. His team of experts and professionals at the Early Learning and Childcare and Social Innovation Office have been working hand in hand with the JQ team to make this happen. Minister Ewasko.
Well, good morning, everyone. It's a pleasure to see everybody here in Stonewall this morning. Again, thanks to my colleagues, MLA Eichler and MLA Wishart for joining us. And of course, Premier, thank you very much for this incredible, incredible announcement. I know many of you are recovering this morning from the great win of the Bombers going to the Grey Cup next year, and look forward to that. In addition to, I'd like to add to a couple things of what Colleen said this morning as well, that when we talk about treaties and the relationship to Manitoba, we actually have to also acknowledge the fact that we are on treaties 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 lands within all of Manitoba. And within that, those are the lands as well. But within that, there are an additional 2 treaties, 6 and 10, that are also signed in regards to our working towards this great province of ours. Today's announcement is incredibly, incredibly exciting and is a great step. And it also shows the great partnership between not only the province and our Department of Education and Early Childhood Learning, but also with the feds. I know that I'd like to acknowledge Ms. Sachs for joining us here today. We've got a great relationship with Minister Gould and able to bring forward this Canada-Manitoba agreement, which allows us to provide these much needed spaces, not only for rural and northern communities, but all across this great province of ours. As we know, it can be very challenging in our rural communities. Often there are not enough spaces. Often people have to drive further to access them. And access to childcare can also affect a family's decision to be able to work outside of the home. These new sites are going to make an incredible difference in Manitoba families. There's going to be more spaces available where they're needed. And in some locations, as you check out the list of locations that are getting some of these first 9, in some cases they were a daycare or childcare space desert. That means that many of the families had to leave their communities to access daycares in other locations. Stonewall today is another example of a great community that is acquiring some spaces, and as we know, many families that need childcare right here in Stonewall, we're accessing childcare spaces in the city of Winnipeg. So today's announcement is definitely going to help alleviate not only those spaces right here in the great community of Stonewall and the others that are participating, but also within the city of Winnipeg. This hybrid construction, which is in conjunction with, again, partnering with municipalities and JQ as well, build, and thank you, Colleen, as well for emceeing this morning. This is a method that is going to be able to build prefab, easy to move, modular units to these various locations. The buildings will be built off-site and moved to a permanent location within the communities. This will allow the buildings to be built to the same high standards as a traditional build, only more quickly. 3 similar childcare centers have opened in recent years in the communities of Gladstone, Russell, and Roblin. Today's announcement builds on other recent large investments we've made to increase the number of childcare centers right here in this great province of ours. A capital investment to create 40 childcare spaces in Oakville, a 48 space expansion at the Young Man's Christian Association of Brandon's Y Downtown Early Learning Center, and a $1 million investment to add additional spaces for newcomers right in the city of Winnipeg. As the Premier has already mentioned, we are committed to 23,000 new regulated not-for-profit childcare spaces for children under the age of 7 across this great province of ours by 2026. I want to thank the Premier for making today's announcement. I want to thank our municipal partners and, of course, our federal partners as well. And with that, thank you to everyone for joining us here this morning for this incredible, incredible announcement.
Well, thank you, Minister Ewasko. This really is an exciting day for Manitoba. This collaborative project has inspired our communities. We have CAOs and community experts that are putting their full weight behind the project to see its collective success. Thank you again for your vision and for your support, and from the support of your whole team. I see Pam Weaver, Tanya Jacobs, and Lily Mallard, who are instrumental in getting us this far on the subject of daycare. So thank you. It is now my great pleasure to invite Parliamentary Secretary Sachs from the Federal Ministry of Families, Children and Social Development to say a few words.
Good morning, everyone. What a wonderful welcome to Manitoba, and what a wonderful welcome to Stonewall. And I want to thank the Premier and Minister Ewasko and everyone here for welcoming us here today. It's such a delight to be here. As we begin, I just want to acknowledge that we're gathering on the traditional territory of the Anishinaabewake, the Oshetuakin, the Cree, and the Anishinaabemowin nations, and also the home of the Métis. This territory is also, as mentioned by Minister Ewasko, Treaty Land 1. I'd like to thank the Veteran Memorial Sports Complex for hosting us today. It's a pleasure to be here with all of you, especially to our young people who are behind us and the families who will really benefit from today's announcement. On September 23, 2020, the Government of Canada said it would create a Canada-wide early learning and childcare system with the provinces and territories. Nous avons amorcé notre parcours visant à transformer la prestation de services de garde d'enfants au pays en nous engageant à verser plus de 27 milliards de dollars sur 5 ans afin de concrétiser cette vision. And what a vision it is. Just over 1 year ago, the governments of Canada and Manitoba signed the Canada-wide Early Learning and Child Care Agreement, which aims to reduce fees, build high-quality, affordable spaces, and ensure early childhood educators are better supported. There is no question child care helps children over the long term. Early childhood educators set up children for success by building their capabilities and confidence, and preparing them for success in school and in life. And this helps our families thrive. Access to high quality, affordable, flexible, and inclusive childcare, no matter where they are, no matter who they are, no matter where they live in this country, has to be a core service for everyone. It's gratifying to work with partners who share a strong commitment to this common goal. Thanks to the hard work and commitment of Premier Stefanson, Minister Ewasko, and their officials, Manitoba is making progress towards lowering parent fees and supporting the goal of achieving an average of $10 a day regulated childcare by March of next year. The province also implemented a new wage grid for more early childhood educators across the province pursue this rewarding career and develop the skills they need to succeed. Il y a encore beaucoup à faire. Nous travaillons à créer les nouvelles places qui sont essentielles pour assurer un accès de services de garde d'enfants. Finding a childcare space is often a struggle for families, especially in our rural and remote communities. For example, when we announced reduced childcare fees for Manitobans with Prime Minister Trudeau and Premier Stefanson, we heard from a family with twins who struggled to find a daycare for both their children. From the start of the process to create a Canada-wide early learning and childcare system, we made it clear that expanding the number of regulated and affordable spaces was key to the success of the system. Right now, Manitoba has just over 25,000 regulated childcare spaces for children up to the age of 6 years. To increase the supply of early learning and childcare spaces, Manitoba has committed to almost doubling that by creating 23,000 full-time, not-for-profit regulated care spaces by the end of 2026. And that is truly an incredible commitment. And for that, families are grateful. Building on the recent early learning and childcare spaces that were announced in June, I am pleased to be here today to support and celebrate the province's announcement to move forward with approximately $70 million in capital funding to support the development of the Childcare Ready to Move pilot project. The project, supported by the provincial and federal governments, will enable the construction of childcare facilities in areas with demonstrated childcare need, as you refer to Minister Ewasko, the childcare deserts that Manitobans are experiencing. Il s'agit d'une étape cruciale vers la création de nouvelles places en service règlement de garde d'enfants dans des communautés où le besoin est grand ici au Manitoba. First Nations and rural communities across the province have a significant need for accessible, high-quality childcare services. We need to get affordable childcare to where it's needed most. This innovative investment will help us create hundreds of spaces in just a few months. We anticipate that this project will create more than 1,200 new childcare spaces in rural communities and First Nations across Manitoba. Capital investments under the $1.2 billion Canada-Manitoba Canada-wide early child learning and child care agreement will support the construction of ready-to-move facilities that will be located in communities with demonstrated child care needs. So this announcement really highlights the progress made under the vision launched in 2020. Encore une fois, je félicite tous ceux et celles qui, ici, au Manitoba, travaillent fort pour accomplir ce travail. Parents appreciate what it means to go out and to work with the comfort of knowing that their child is in competent and caring hands. We are committed to that, Manitoba is committed to that, and families are grateful. Thank you to all, and merci.
Well, thank you, Parliamentary Secretary Sachs. We are really excited to share the progress of this pilot project with you and the federal colleagues. We believe that this Made in Manitoba solution has much to offer other jurisdictions across Canada who are also interested in new and innovative ways to work together to deliver critical infrastructure to their communities. I would now like to invite Brad Erb, reeve of Macdonald, and chair of JQ Daycare in a Box pilot project to say a few words.
Thank you, Colleen, and I want to thank you, Premier Stefanson and Minister Ewasko, for your vision and leadership, supporting partnerships and collaboration across governments and across communities. Today's announcement is about delivering critical infrastructure to our communities, as well as supporting collaboration that demonstrates that it is possible when we work together. Local governments working as partners are a powerful force in delivering infrastructure and service to our communities. By working across boundaries and jurisdictions, pooling our resources and sharing in our capacities, communities, large, small, urban, rural, northern, and indigenous can ensure residents have what they need long into the future. The JQ Daycare Pilot Project provides a platform that creates a team from across governments, a team of leaders, CAOs, public works staff, and planning staff, who, when called upon, rolled up their sleeves, designed a method to expedite and support the delivery of child care spaces. The partners in the first round of this pilot project have provided 2 acres of service land, as has already been indicated, and 15 years of rent-free operation for qualified nonprofit daycare operators. We hope, along with the efforts of the federal government and the provincial government combined, with the contributions of local governments, we can provide the needed spaces, support economic development, support qualified licensed nonprofit providers, ensuring they are successful in our communities. Local governments are excited to support the delivery of this important infrastructure, an easy-to-follow process that allows for the quality daycare facilities to be built in an expedited fashion. And we are committed to support other communities as they come online in subsequent phases. I want to acknowledge my colleagues and partners in the JQ Daycare in a Box Round 1 who have wholeheartedly supported the process and have come out to join us in this exciting announcement today. And I'll just name a few of them. Fanier Macdonald, our CAO, Daryl Raharchuk, Mayor Chris Ewan and Mitch Duvall from Risho, Mayor Smith and CAO Wally Melnick from Stonewall, Mayor Feeblecorn, CAO Deepak Joshi from St. Clement's, from the Arm of Portage, Mayor Tufford and CEO Nettie Newdorf. City of Portage is Mayor Knox and CEO Nathan Pito. Peguas First Nation, Chief Hudson and the Real Estate Trustee Greg Stefanson. Arm of Whitemouth, Mayor Armagon and CEO Colleen Johnson. The Arm of Morris, Mayor Siemens and CEO Larry Dreger. And the Arm of Headingley, Mayor Robson and CEO Sandra Miller. As well, I want to, in a collaborative fashion, acknowledge the municipalities that are part of JQ, John Q, that are not in First Goal communities, but we're excited about the opportunity to work collaboratively as well, and that's the Arm of St. Andrews, Arm of Rockwood, Arm of Taché, Arm of East St. Paul, Arm of Rossard, and the Arm of Springfield. I also want to acknowledge and thank all the other local government staff and provincial experts who have been involved in developing this process. Thank you for all your efforts. As well as the leadership and staff at the Winnipeg Metropolitan Region, JQ Project, who have been instrumental in organizing the administrative support. Again, thank you to Yara Sachs, Premier Stefanson, and Minister Roski for your vision and leadership. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Reverb, for providing some detail on the partners of this important collaboration. And we are very grateful to the town of Stonewall, one of our Phase 1 partners, for hosting this exciting announcement today. And to welcome us all properly to this wonderful community, I'd like to welcome Mayor Sandra Smith to provide a formal welcome to all of us before we conclude the program for today.
Thank you, Colleen. On behalf of my fellow councillors who are here with me this morning, it is my extreme pleasure to welcome all of you to the town of Stonewall. To Premier Stefanson, we are honored that you are here today to be a part of this incredible announcement. Thank you to our local MLA, Ralph Eichler, for being here and for being such a strong advocate for Lakeside. And also thank you to MLA Wishart. I would like to acknowledge the commitment by the province of Manitoba as a signatory to an agreement with the Government of Canada, which has initiated a significant investment in the creation of an early learning and childcare program. Thank you to Minister Ewasko and his team for their work in ensuring that this program is addressing the need for full-time regulated childcare spaces in our province. For our town and others across the province, daycare is essential and urgently needed. Currently in Stonewall, we have children waiting for daycare spots. This pilot project will allow us to significantly shorten this waiting list and deliver daycare spots in time for the start of the next school year. As a bedroom community, the provision of daycare has a direct impact on our town's success and ability to grow. Insufficient daycare is a bottleneck in the economic activity of our community, and as such, Stonewall is delighted to have been included in the first round of the selection process by the province of Manitoba as one of 9 communities, all of which have been identified as having a significant need to participate in the pilot project delivery method created by JQ Built. This is a real game changer, and it is exciting to know that there are other communities waiting to sign on to this pilot project. The uniqueness of the JQ Built initiative and its out-of-the-box approach to a significant need in Manitoba can be attributed to Colleen Sklar, the executive director of the Winnipeg Metropolitan Region. Thank you to her and the steering committee for their time and expertise in getting this project off the ground. I would especially like to acknowledge our own CAO, Wally Melnick, for his work on behalf of our town. This initiative is one of many to come and demonstrates the strength of collaboration and partnership and is a testament to the vision created with our municipal partners of the Winnipeg Metropolitan Region in establishing John Q. Public. We are better, stronger, and more resilient when we work together. I would like to thank the children and staff from Stonewall Children's Center and Starting Blocks, along with members of their respective boards, for joining us here today. If you look outside these doors across the field, both of the facilities are located there, and that is also the location of our new build. We acknowledge and appreciate not only the service that the facilities provide to our town, but to all of the child care facilities across the province. You are critical to the success of all of our communities, and we are grateful for the thought and input provided to this project. Thanks again for joining us. I invite you to stay for refreshments and to celebrate this exciting announcement with us. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much, Mayor Smith. This really is a groundbreaking partnership, and I want to again thank the federal government, Premier Stefanson, Minister Ewasko, for believing in this approach and supporting JQ in a box process. We look forward to partnering with the province and delivering critical infrastructure in Manitoba. I have to say that I've sat at the table for many years as we collaborate and try and work together, but this process really takes us from beyond the business as usual approach to a new way of doing things, a new way that provides the critical services for all Manitobans. Before we end today, I would be remiss if I didn't say a special thank you to all the CAOs in the pilot project who have spent countless hours working on this model. I also want a very special thanks to Deepak Joshi, CAO of St. Clements, Wally Melnick, Town of Stonewall, Colleen Johnson, CAO of RM of Whitemouth, Daryl Hererchuk, the CAO of Macdonald, as well as Anuj Kothari, Jennifer Freeman, Joe Lutzi, and Orville Curry from the JQ Built team. It is because of your dedication to this project that we are here today with this announcement. And thank you to all of you for coming out to this announcement today. This concludes the formal part of the announcement, and we will now open for questions from the media, followed by a photo with today's participants, as well as all of the